Let's get over to Megan and Derek now for traffic and weather together.
It's over now for Missouri. It's tapering off for Illinois, still going strong in Indiana. So if the kids, we're talking about colleges, heading to Purdue, heading to IU today, big troubles because they are going to find quite extensive accumulation totals around that neck of the woods, too. It's not pretty out there, guys. It begins to infiltrate you guys around Gary and Portage and Merrillville and St. John down to Dyer. So looking around points south is really where we expect to find the heavier accumulation. And look here, lo and behold, Jed, south, you're going to find some brighter whites. And the real intense stuff is more towards central Indiana at this point, but dropped about a foot plus across many areas of central Illinois. 33 degrees right now if you're hitting the door at Midway. 34 for Gary, 31 Valparaiso, 31 for Kankakee, about 32 for Waukegan, and 27 for DeKalb.
Wait, traffic and weather together. Here's Megan.
Remember the first big bullet we dodged this year? It was central Indiana, central Illinois. So hopefully this is the last storm. We're dodging bullets with all the storm system accumulation to the south. Maybe on the very end of the very beginning. Probably not. But you know what? At this point, at least we know that it's getting better for folks across our areas. The system not only heads to the east, but most of the snow, in terms of the heavier stuff, is well to the south of us. We have just a few areas of some light snow showers. That's generally going to be the trend throughout the course of the day today because that low pressure sits right around Cincinnati, Ohio right now. It continues to progress on off towards the mid-Ohio Valley, and that's going to take the snow with it. But it'll take a while, and then it's going to take quite a while for them to dig out from 12 to 16 inches of snow. That's what I'm seeing in terms of accumulation that's happened for the folks in central Illinois. For us, yes, some snow showers, light in intensity, but there is a potential today, especially across the areas shaded in the light blue here, for some lake effect snow because of fairly strong northeasterly winds out there. Those winds are also going to create an issue for us in terms of how it feels.
Florida, but nothing near that.
I was in Miami and got out of there middle of the day or so on Saturday, but you know, generally that sort of damage when the trees almost pushed down entirely, not snapped in the trunk somewhere, is usually from straight line winds because they just push it straight over. When you see trees snapped and lying in different directions, that often denotes tornado activity. So, you know, you can find plenty of damage with just regular. Make these temperatures that are right now in the freezing range feel quite a bit colder. Coldest temperature I have on my map is 26 at DeKalb. It's about 32 around Midway, but feels more like the teens for everyone. Your radar picture is going to show you a little bit of light snow coming on shore in Lake and Porter County in Indiana, and a few light areas of some snowfall down around Will County in southern Cook County. Heading down 57 right now, which is where we found Mobile 2 just a while ago. As he continues to move south, you're going to run into more intense snowfall and quite a bit of accumulation, especially in the area under the winter storm warning that's up for about another 40 minutes. The purple shaded area is a winter weather advisory that as well is up until 7 a.m. this morning. Low pressure system continues to progress on off to the east, taking the snow with it, but we'll keep at least some snow showers in the forecast today because wrapping around that low pressure system, we'll see northeasterly winds coming down over the lake. So that's going to bring about the potential for some lake effect snow into the second half of the day for us, especially if you're around Cook County or over into Lake County in Indiana or even up into Lake County in Illinois. So snow showers in the forecast today. Accumulations from this point forward should be very minimal for us down to the south and especially in towards central Indiana at this point. They're going to see some pretty vigorous weather. Our temperatures just 36 degrees, that's at least 10 degrees below average. It's going to be breezy and feel even colder, and that will continue. We're talking about Willow's getting ready to walk. Sorry, I just was digressing there. We will, we'll talk about the forecast out there. We'll do that too, I promise. Mm-hmm. And of course, quite a bit of snow out there to the south.
And we'll talk about those road conditions. A couple of them are slowing up. We'll let you know where coming up.
Really getting hit hard.
Yeah, you know what? Absolutely. It's central Illinois. It's central Indiana. It's parts of Ohio. It's definitely been pounded there, D. And we're talking about, you know, accumulations of a foot, foot and a half there. Yeah, it's not, it's a lot of snow. And so very hard to dig out of that. It happened generally overnight. And so those folks are still contending with that. We take a look at what's going on in our radar picture right now. And there's not that much heavier, brighter white color. And you're going to see that's generally south of South Bend in towards central Indiana. And that's where the heaviest stuff is right now. For us, we're farther away from that low pressure system. They're a little bit closer. That's why when the low was on off towards St. Louis. We were getting pounded in central Illinois. Now that it's progressed on off towards Ohio, they're being pounded around Indianapolis and up to the north a little bit around Lafayette and Kokomo. And that low continues to progress on off to the east today. For us, it's just some scattered.
And props to Tim King. He's the man who's been running urban prep and doing great things for all those young people and getting their lives in order. Mm-hmm. It is 6:36, traffic and weather together. Megan, we can't complain about the cold when we look what's going on elsewhere.
That's very true, but you think we could hire him to maybe do something with our weather? Get
maybe.
Our weather in line. It doesn't feel like spring. It doesn't act like spring. But lo and behold, it is. It's just going to be a spring day with some snow showers coming and going and potentially a bit of lake effect in towards the second half of the day. Temperature-wise, we top out today mid-30s. It's about 10 degrees below average, everyone. We should not be there this time of the year. We should be up into flirting with 50. That range would be much more likely. But yet we deal with snow out there. We see the possibility of very, very heavy snow across parts of central Illinois and central Indiana. We're talking about a foot plus has already fallen across parts of central Illinois down around Champaign.
Time now, 6:45. Traffic and weather together. It's just a mess. Everywhere you look, it's a mess.
You know what? It's true. And you know what? For them, this is the time of the year where we don't like it, but it tends to start happening. The severe storms, the possible tornado activity. While for us, technically, we should be getting some rain showers, very typical of early spring, a few thunderstorms thrown. 30-mile-an-hour range in terms of gusts, and so that's going to make the 30s feel much more like the teens and 20s. Radar picture showing a few light snow showers across the area. Generally, that's what we expect to see today, first from the system as this low pressure continues to progress on off to the east. And then later on today, the possibility of some lake effect snow will rev up as the low continues to bring northeasterly winds down over the lake and push that possibility of lake effect snow really from the Wisconsin border there all the way down through Lake County, Cook County, and probably into Lake and maybe extreme western parts of Porter County in Indiana. We're not talking about a lot of accumulation from this, but don't be surprised to see it in the areas that I've highlighted there this morning, because later on today, those northeasterly winds will build up enough moisture that we could potentially see, again, some lake effect coming into play. Big dip in the jet stream has allowed for some very cold air to settle in around here. The wet stuff is locked to the south and east. The cold, dry air is trying to filter in. And man, is it cold. We're talking about 10 degrees below average out there, at least today and really into the day tomorrow. We begin to warm up.
For a check of the forecast.
I have a theory. Our very first storm system, we dodged a bullet, and maybe this is the last. Highly doubtful. We'll always have to keep a peek at the weather, of course. But low pressure progressing on off to the east now, leaving central Illinois in a much better place. But they picked up as much as 15, 16, 17 inches of snow across parts of central Illinois. Now central Indiana is getting the brunt of it, while we just have a few scattered snow showers, lighter in their intensity up across Chicagoland. You can see here just a few areas of some very light flurry activity. Now into the afternoon with a strong northeasterly wind flow, we do have the possibility of some lake effect snow. So that's the next thing to watch out for. We'll talk more about that and your 7-day forecast coming up.
Okay, thank you, Megan. More on the snow.
That's remarkable.
Yeah, isn't that cool?
Oh, Megan, here now. It's also kind of remarkable that we dodged this big storm.
We dodged it big time. But if anyone's got kids downstate in college or down at Indiana University or even Purdue University, they may have had a hard time getting back to school. Maybe even had classes canceled because they picked up almost 18 inches of snow around Springfield. So we're talking about a lot of snow downstate. We take a look at what's going on around here. It feels like just 26 degrees at Midway and O'Hare, 21 for Aurora, 20 DeKalb, and about 24 degrees or so around Waukegan, and that's the feels like temperature. Snow has pushed eastward. A little bit of light snowfall expected across the area today in terms of just some very light snow flurries or potentially as much as what you'd qualify it as a snow shower, but generally not picking up any more in the way of accumulation. Didn't get much from the system anyway. It was primarily towards central portion of the state, which right now is getting a chance to dig out as well. While it's still snowing for a good majority of the Hoosier state right now, that low pressure system situated just really kind of south of Columbus, right in the Mid-Ohio River Valley, and it's pushing on off to the east slowly, but surely. For us, at this moment, we do have a little bit of light snow around Joliet, a touch around Waukegan, and do have the potential later today with a fairly strong northeasterly flow to pick up a bit of lake effect snow in Lake and Cook County in Illinois, as well as Lake and extreme western Porter in Indiana. Unseasonably cold weather is in play today, certainly with highs expected to be in the mid-30s. Ridge of high pressure over Canada has allowed for warmer than normal temperatures way up near the Arctic Circle. But for us, we're talking about this cold air that's just being forced south and making for colder than average conditions. We should be in the upper 40s this time of the year, but no dice today. We're going to be seeing some snow showers from time to time, breezy conditions that will make our 36 degree high feel a lot colder than that. For tonight, you're going to find temperatures right around 30 degrees or so. Breezy with a few light snow showers lingering, and then going into tomorrow, mostly cloudy. It feels like winter. 38 for tomorrow. A little bit better than today, but not by much, frankly. And somewhat mild weekend. However, we've got to wait all the way until Saturday to see it.
Unbelievable.
Yeah, bundle up till then.
Okay, thank you, Megan.
We can wait.
We can wait. Just a little bit longer, not much.
Thanks, Megan. Okay.